मंत्री निलेश काब्राल यांनी वकिलांवर केलेले विधान मागे घ्यावे, अन्यथा त्यांना पदावरून हटवावे अशी मागणी राज्यातील वकिलांनी केली. मंत्री काब्राल यांनी वकील आकारत असलेल्या फीजवर विधान केलं होतं. तसंच केलेलं विधान मंत्र्यांनी मागे घ्यावं अशी विनंती वकिलांनी केली होती, मात्र त्यांनी कोणताही प्रतिसाद न दिल्यानं त्यांच्या भूमिकेचा आझाद मैदानावर निषेध करण्यात आला.
We feel that the minister should behave in a respectful manner to the lawyer and take back his statement. That would put an hiatus to this issue and it will not go further. If not, then the lawyers would be forced to take recourse to the courts of law because it amounts to defamation.
Defamation.
When he says that this is what is being done and it is against the law or it is overcharged and all this. This is straight away a case for defamation.
So but I would advise the
civil as well as criminal. So the lawyer, the Nilesh should be well advised to take back his comments and put a hiatus on this issue.
To file a defamation, but in the same right, he will allow member of our one of the bar association to defend him in court of law. Because he will need a lawyer there as well. See, we will never say, no lawyer will represent him.
In person.
Because in person he cannot. He will not understand what is defamation, criminal or civil. Apart from that, see, we condemn the defamatory statement of Nilesh. Yes, and we will ask even our member to take less fee.
Legal aid.
We'll provide him legal aid.
Legal aid.
The best legal aid. Legal aid service. See, we had a good relationship with the journalist. Ever you heard we charge exorbitant fees from you? Never. Actually, I have seen many journalists sitting in our journalist service to give advice. But that's not the case. This statement, derogatory statement, it is uncalled for. And it is not meant. As a minister, is immoral, unethical, unwarranted, and against question of social justice.
All India Lawyers Union had called for an apology by the minister, whereas the various law forums, advocates forums, and associations from Goa had called for withdrawal of his statement. We waited for 2 weeks. On 11th, we had issued this statement of our forums and associations. Now, more than 2 weeks have passed and the Honorable Minister has totally ignored our statement and our calls for either withdrawal of his comments or for an apology. In the circumstances, we were constrained to protest against these statements.
Today, if a lawyer is charging certain fees for conveyancing, it is the lawyer who knows what effort goes into that particular aspect of the matter. The law minister sitting in his chamber cannot say that we have charged exorbitant fees and that too on some hearsay. If you have seen that video, he says that somebody came and told me that lawyers are charging high fees. He should be more concerned. And if he is really concerned about the common man, my question to the Honorable Law Minister is, on what basis has he increased the stamp duties? On what basis has he increased the court fees for the common man to approach the court in Goa? On what basis has he increased the land rates in Goa? And all this is done without consultation with the common man. All this is done without any consultation with any member of the bar. This is all done by him unilaterally. So if he can increase fees the way he wants through his Department of Law and Justice, I question him as to on what basis is he questioning the authority of lawyer to charge fees. Now he says that I'm going to so much simplify the process that a lawyer's help will not be required by a common man.
Shame.
I'm giving a challenge to the Honorable Law Minister that do such simplification and show.
Yes.
We are happy if a common man does not need the lawyer, if you can do such a simplification. And my request to him is also simplify the rest of the procedures in the state where the state will not require lawyers. It's a challenge to him.
Yes.
And I'm sure he will never be able to do this because it is us lawyers who defend the rights of the common men when these politicians violate their rights.
Protect their
Just
their
half
rights.
An hour back, I have seen a digital news that some youth from Wasco went to raise some grievance before a minister from Wasco. And that they have been abused or some incident has happened and the MLAs have not supported this common man. Now, where are these common men going to go? they are going to come to us lawyers to fight cases against these ministers. When the ministers are dragged to the court, where do the ministers go? They come to us lawyers to defend them. And there they are willing to pay whatever fees the lawyers charge because they want to save their skins. So what is the moral ground for the minister to today say that the lawyer is charging X amount of fee? Please leave it to the lawyers. We know what we are doing. Goa is in safe hands of lawyers. Goa has a very good bar. And this efforts of the bar and the sincerity and dedication of the bar has been acknowledged by various judges who have visited the state of Goa.
We charge our clients because of the expertise. And as lawyers, which my friends are here, I know we do 20 years research of the title report. And that goes in the sale date. 20 years title report. So amka sangtalo Nilesh Kabral. It's going to make you very simplify. Will he title search every sale date which is happening in Goa? He will not do that. For title search report, according to sale date, we do it. It's not just copy, cut, paste what he said. That is going to make it very simplified. It's not that simplified procedure. We charge our clients according to our expertise. We charge our client according to our experience. If he thinks that it is overmuch, he has no right. He is a lawyer, so he should know that. What I want to say is very simple. Okay, this Agun Sutta. What I want to say is simple. Tukatar Distani that Ami charge overcharge Kartani. So two practice on Yomare. Why have you become a politician? You come into practice and make all this money. Why have you become a politician? And don't just simply blame the politicians and simply blame the lawyers by this. Lawyers Forum is strongly condemning your statement. Mr. Gabral, I think you should resign and you should resign gracefully.
And what representation to him? He makes one statement, some freak statement in a press statement and casts aspersion on a lawyer. What right does he have? What morality he has? What jurisdiction does he have? Absolutely no locus standi, as rightly said by Advocate Gurwant Singh. I want our, in fact we are all here, all seven forums, including our All India Lawyers Union, which has condemned his defamatory remarks, and we had asked for an apology or withdrawal of his statement, failing which we would like to go.
साडी शॉपिंग करपाक आता बेळगाव वचपाची गरज ना. पणजीतल्या बॉम्बे बाजारांत तुमका दर्जेदार प्रकारच्या साड्यो खरेदी करपाक मेळटा. नवीन व्हंकलेक नववारी असो किंवा उत्तर भारतीय लहंगा, सिल्क साडी किंवा कॉटन साडी, तुमची पसंत आणि आमचे कलेक्शन. साडी स्वतः खातीर खरेदी करा किंवा गिफ्ट करा. बॉम्बे बाजार, 18 जून रोड, पणजी.